you want your asset library to look as smooth as this? Don't we all? Keep watching and you will learn the ins and outs of a tool that's essential for a unified library, batch rename. Why do you need it? Imagine it's Monday morning. The sun is probably shining. You have a hot beverage at hand and you are ready to face the world. But first, you have to organize what you received from freelancers and collaborators. Instead of the smooth library you dream about, you get something that can be just described as a total mess. Because having a naming convention often doesn't apply to everyone. Take a deep breath, select the first batch of assets, and open the batch rename tool. In it, you can further narrow the selections and apply renaming conditions only to certain assets. For example, after adding the diffuse suffixes to all textures, you can grab the ones with different patterns and remove the extra symbols. Note how you can preview the changes in the new file name column. And even if you made a mistake, you can undo the changes while the tool is opened. The cleanup features at the bottom are your friends for quickly stripping characters that are often used, like the underscore that you can replace with an empty space. Just a few seconds, and the first part of the Monday nightmare is resolved. The second involves the renaming of final renderings. Giving them proper names is needed for showcasing to clients and auto-assigning them as previews. Again, you can use the cleanup options and combine them with adding the product name at the end. That was easy. The third set of assets comes with lots of suffixes for rendering engines and software versions. When you use Connector, they're not really needed because the metadata of the assets can be used for filtering. So the logical step is to remove those specific parts of the file names. You can use the replace function to clear them up quickly. The fourth nightmarish scenario includes assets with file names beyond repair. Sometimes, all the cleaning up features can't save the mess you get. In that case, it's a good idea to start from scratch by deleting the current names and then adding new ones in batches. As you can see, Connector alerts you when the new file names are duplicated. To fix that, just add numbering and place it at the end by changing the direction. You can repeat this action multiple times across different selections. Now that all new assets are following consistent naming patterns, you can organize them easily and continue with your daily tasks. And thanks to Connector's batch rename tool, your coffee should still be hot. Follow us for more tips and convenient workflows about Connector.